We took a previous look at Upper Deck's first foray into 007 with the James Bond collection, but with two boxes here, with a second box sitting in my house, and knowing that there's Roger Moore autos in there and Sean Connery cuts, I don't know. I just thought maybe we should dive in for a second look. Plus, the first time we opened it, I was a little confused by the base set coloring and thought that there were several different parallels, and I was bummed that there were so many parallels and yada yada yada. Well, it just turns out that those were end up being various levels of short printing, not necessarily parallels, so we can address that a little bit more fully. So look for a variety of actor autographs, and I know the Bond ladies have a strong presence in here as well. In fact, we pulled one last time. Who was it we pulled? What,
It was Jane
Jane
Seymour.
Seymour.
Yep.
Yeah, Jane Seymour. So yeah, I thought this was like a red parallel. No, it's just when you get up to that high in numbering, this the color scheme changes and indicates a level of short printedness, if that's a word. Is that a
Yeah.
word?
You just said it, so
I guess it is.
yeah. But there's a big thing with entertainment sets, which is they're only as good as their checklist. And if that's true, if you hold that philosophy like I do, this is a really good set. Really incredible checklist. The autograph signers is very deep. You can actually get the whole checklist from gogts.net. Just check out there and Google 007.
Well, if you're, when you said that, it's funny that you mentioned that. Actually, I left this card up here to show you that this is the real parallel. Those silver with the blue foil at the top, that's a legit parallel. You'll be happy to know I'm working on an article for the GoGTS.net blog that basically, I think it's titled, Reasons Why a Collector Should Thank These A-List Celebrities, and talking about, the products that have been released through the years that were able to land key guys, the top stars, things of that nature. And then
Interesting.
there'll be a subsequent article about the sets that fell short.
Now, are you going to go deep with some of the ones like Meghan Markle in Fringe Series 4 or
Oh
like
yeah, oh
Ryan
yeah.
Reynolds and okay,
De
good. I hope you have some
definitely.
more examples that I can turn to that you uncovered, because that's one of the things I love about entertainment sets of today is like you never know who in Game of Thrones Season 5 is 20 years from now going to be an Oscar winner or marry a
I know.
prince,
I mean, listen, when Angelina Jolie signed for Tomb Raider with Inkworks in what, 2003? I mean, nobody envisioned her being a future Academy and Golden Globe Award actress. So yeah, it should be, I think you'll like it. It should be fun.
Well, to be fair, didn't she win the Academy Award in 1998?
Well, yeah, maybe so, but
Sorry.
you know what I mean? I
2000.
mean,
2000. Girl interrupted. But yes, I would say she
yeah,
became an even
really. And
bigger
that
action star a little after that.
movie. I mean, come on, that was Girl Interrupted.
Rob's opinions are shaped by being interrupted by girls constantly at home.
Well, you know.
It's like it's about time someone interrupted that girl. You know how often I get interrupted?
What is it? 7-3 Green Bay.
Don't know. I'm still waiting on Anthony Rizzo to hit a home run. It's not looking good. Oh, wait, no, it is looking good. Yasmani Grandal just tied up the game on a
So I'm gonna have to change the
home run.
wording in that to multiple award winning or multi something. I didn't realize it was 98 when she, or 2000 when she won that.
Yeah, 1999 was the Golden Globe, 2000 was the Oscar.
So it's even maybe more remarkable that she signed autographs for Tomb Raider. Especially not needing to, probably, after then. I mean, she went on to become, for several years, Hollywood's leading paid actress. And probably why she's never signed anything again.
So, yes, well, so Tomb Raider, the movie, was 2001, so it might have been that...
She signed before the actual... Well, no, because...
Well, but really that...
When was production finished for each of those movies?
Yeah, so it might have been, one, put into her contract. Two, even though she had won the Academy Award, she was an outlier to win that. She wasn't a movie star.
Tiffany
that
Case,
kind of put her on the radar.
Diamonds Are Forever.
It wasn't like today where you have to star in a Marvel film before you can get cast in anything else.
Right. Well, so. No. I mean, yeah, in the article I talk about, you know, you look at a set like Parks and Recreation, very interesting. So Chris Pratt didn't sign, went on to become huge in the MCU. Paul Rudd did sign and also went on to become pretty big in the MCU. And mm-hmm. both of them, one of their most notable appearances. This acetate is another type of parallel. Those are pretty rare. That might even be more case hit like.
Eight per case. But they are a bounty card as well.
Oh, that's cool.
So with 12 boxes in a case, they're one in every other box.
Robert Carlyle as Renard is our on-card auto.
Ooh. Oh, can you move a card for just a second so I can get that picture? There we go. Awesome, thank you.
It's another type of parallel. They're distinguished by the foil bordering. All right, so no Roger Moore. I thought it might be in there.
Who is your second autograph?
Haven't found it yet. I don't think you're guaranteed two autos.
It says two autos.
Well, let's see.
And we got two autos last time. I can't remember who the other one. The other one was the character Felix Leiter, but it was him in the original Casino Royale, not Jeffrey Wright.
Well, if there is one, it's in here because this is the last pack.
James Campanos, didn't you say you have a second box? No, this is actually the second box. We opened a box of this.
Oh, cool. It's not Roger Moore, but it is Miss Moneypenny.
Oh, very cool.
All right, we'll get both of those autos away.
You know what this product does for me, Rob? It just makes me want to go watch some James Bond movies.
It really does.